Hello, it's Polish Paul VR. Welcome to the channel. I hope you all alright and I hope you all having good day. And speaking about good things, today we're gonna talk about little robot called Richie, because I've got very nice story about it coming from this year's CES, so maybe let's just jump into it. So Richie is a little robot that company called Pollen Robotics been working on, and he is pretty unique, because Richie is an expressive open source humanoid platform programmable with Python. He is very good at interacting with people and manipulating objects. What's cool about it, he is running on open source software and also open source hardware, and he can be 3D printed. So I'm gonna put all the links in the description in case you want to get your own Richie. But what I want to talk about it is something even better and something what viewers of my channel probably gonna appreciate, because the developers of Richie introduced the VR teleportation application for it. So what you can do, you can put your headset on and then you can control Richie like that. Basically, you place in your body in a body of a robot with the VR technology, of course. To me, basically, this is looks like future is kind of now. And thanks to the open source of it and the kind of accessibility with being it 3D printed, it's gonna probably evolve to something cool in the future. Of course, this is an early steps, but at least we can see it happening right now in front of our eyes. So Richie gonna be super cool project to follow. You can see the video while people using VR headset and kind of their body to manipulate robot's body, and this technology kind of can have endless possibilities in the future when it's more developed. I mean, it's pretty cool now. I really like what I'm seeing and I cannot wait to show it to my father-in-law, because he loves 3D printing, he loves programming and he loves to do cool stuff, so cannot wait for him to see it. But anyway, so what's Richie is like a potential of Richie in the future? Imagine for some reason we've got, fingers crossed, it's not gonna happen, but even more severe pandemic. Imagine going, I don't know, to shop and your cashier, whatever, the shop person who needs to give you a parcel or something, operates this robot remotely from home. How cool. Now they saying he's already very good at manipulating object, reaching for stuff. The tracking itself from VR to real world, it looks like it translates very, very good. For me, it's one of those exciting projects, and this is a project what I loved to see at this year's CES. There was so much cool stuff, so I probably gonna fetch her some more videos from CES. But nevertheless, Richie is the one that captured my imagination the most, because of course of this virtual reality integration. And this is something what you might kind of seen in past in the movies, like your 80s, 70s or even 90s sci-fi movies. That's what's been happening there, and now it's happening in real life. And the technology is amazing. I mean, I know many of you got 3D printers at home. I know many of you can even, you know, be quite good at programming and exploring open source software and stuff like that. So I'm glad the developers made it so, so accessible for everyone. And what a nice heartwarming story for days like this when most of the world is still in the lockdown. So yeah, I like the Richie a lot. I'm gonna try to fetch a Richie in the future, because it's the story I want to follow. But nevertheless, let me know in the comment section what you think about it all. Actually, you can let me know what you think about potential of this technology and its implementation in real life world, and how can it be useful. And also let me know if it's something you want to grab for yourself and what you would do with it. So all the links, what you need to all the videos, to the website, I'm gonna put it in the description. Like I said, you can get this robot right now if you want to. So you can go to the website and check it out. I actually didn't go as far to see how much it's cost and everything. But nevertheless, for those of you who maybe have a lot of money, it might come useful. I don't know. But yeah, let me know what you think. And of course, stay tuned to the channel for all the information from the virtual reality world. support PC VR, PlayStation VR and Oculus Quest. And of course, if you like what you're seeing, then please press a like because it does helps the channel a lot. And if you're new to the channel and are not subscribed, then subscribe. It's always better when it's more of us. And that's it, bye.